Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm super excited to show you something amazing, which is Grok 3 and its fantastic image generation. In this video, I'll show you how it works step by step and why prompt engineering is the key to unlocking its full potential. So let's go to the browser and we can head to grok.com. If you're new to Grok, you'll need an account to log in here. You can use your Twitter or X account if you have one. When I'm in, we are ready to start creating some technical drawings. So let's start with a basic example. For my first prompt, I'm going to enter this to draw a top-down 3D floor plan of a luxury mansion with neutral tones, photorealistic soft shadows, isometric perspective, and intricate details. Grok 3 processes this for a few seconds. As you can see, here are the two generated images. You can see a 3D floor plan with a few rooms, doors, and windows. It's clean and functional, but it's missing specific details like unique features or a particular style. It's a great starting point, but let's see how we can level it up with better prompt engineering. For our second prompt, I'm going to add more detail. This time, my input is draw a top-down 3D floor plan of a luxury mansion with organic modern plus Art Deco fusion. Curved plaster walls, light oak floors, travertine kitchen island, gold geometric chandelier, and panoramic windows, neutral tones with emerald green, velvet accents, photorealistic, soft shadows, isometric perspective, intricate details. So let's submit this one. Notice how I have included specific elements this time. This guy's Grok 3. To create something more complex and tailored. This is where prompt engineering shines. By being more descriptive, we are telling the AI exactly what we want, which leads to a higher quality output. Check this out. We've got a luxury mansion with lots of details this time. If you want to see more details, you can choose the two generated images. You can use the options below the images to fine-tune more. So the first prompt gave us a basic floor plan, solid but generic. The second, with more details, produced an accurate and impressive design. Let's review the power of prompt engineering in a second example. This time, our prompt is draw a hyper-realistic image of a wind turbine with neutral tones, photorealistic, soft shadows, isometric perspective with intricate details. Pretty straightforward, right? Let's feed this into the AI and see what it generates. Here are the two images that we've got. As you can see, the full wind turbine in a photorealistic style. The neutral tones and soft shadows give it a clean and professional look this time, and the isometric perspective lets us view the whole structure clearly. While this is a solid overview, it's not quite detailed enough. If we are designing or analyzing a wind turbine, we'd want more focus on specific components. These components are the motor and the blades and their mechanical details. This image is great for a general impression, but it's missing that close-up precision we need. So how do we level up? The answer is refining our prompt. Again, prompt engineering is all about being specific. And instead of saying wind turbine, we can specify which parts to focus on and describe texture, set the lighting and even tell the AI what to leave out. It's an iterative process. We start simple, see the results, then tweak the prompt to get closer to your goal. Let's craft a more detailed prompt and see how it transforms the output. This time we say draw an ultra detailed 3D render of a wind turbine's motor and blades. Close up perspective, show sleek aerodynamic fiberglass blades with realistic surface texture attached to the rotor hub. Style is photorealistic, studio lighting, dark background with rim light for depth. No labels, no annotations, no tower or foundation. Focus on mechanical precision and material textures like fiberglass and brushed metal. So as you can see, two images are generated. Take a look at this. We've got a stunning ultra detailed view of the motor and the blades this time. The fiberglass blades are sleek and textured, perfectly attached to the rotor hub. This studio lighting highlights every curve and surface. And that rim light against the dark background makes the mechanical details pop up. It's a huge step up for a technical drawing. It's precise, it's focused, and shows the engineering details we need for design or analysis. Way more useful than the first image we generated from this wind turbine. Here are my final tips to master AI image generation with prompt engineering. Be descriptive, use words like spacious or modern to add flavor. Specify key features, call out things like swimming pool or blades or specific details. Also, set the style. Try adding contemporary or eco-friendly to shape the design. With a little bit of practice, you can create technical drawings that are both practical and creative. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more technical content. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.